Welcome back to the Jim Green Footwear channel. Today we're going to be diving into one of the more frequently asked questions that we are getting lately. And that is, what is the difference between the legend of our range, the old bull, the Razorback, and the new kid on the block, the African Ranger? In this video, we're going to be running through the boots spec by spec, and by the end of it, you'll get a better idea of which boot is better suited for you. So on either side of the boots here, we have a deconstructed African Ranger and a deconstructed Razorback, and we're going to be taking a closer look at all the components of these boots. Before we have a closer look at each spec of these boots, I'm going to give you a brief overview of what each boot is about. The Jim Green Razorback is a boot inspired by Africa, designed to take on the daily outdoor and work challenges that come with the harsh terrain. Its fully leather-lined upper combines with a rubber sole to give you stability, comfort, and grip. For over 30 years, the Jim Green Razorback has been the choice of South Africa's safari lodges and outdoor enthusiasts, famous for its never-say-die attitude and respected for its durability. No other boot is more versatile. From mountaintops to factory floors, the Razorback is ready for any challenge. And mile after mile, year after year, the Razorback is an old friend you can always count on to get you from here to there in rugged comfort. So now onto our most recent boot that we have added to the range, our African Ranger. Since we came out with this boot almost a year ago, we have had such great feedback on it, so thanks to all of you for the support. Just a reminder, and for those new to Jim Green and what this boot is about, is that for every 10 pairs that we sell, we donate a pair to a ranger in need. When we came out with this boot, we had three main focus areas. First one was that the boot needed to be durable. The second one is that the boot needed to be comfortable. And the third one is that these two factors had to combine to make this an affordable option. Over 50% of rangers do not have access to sufficient boots and gear, and over 40% are required to purchase their own boots, which is arguably their most important piece of gear, as these rangers are trekking anywhere from 5 to 20 kilometers a day, which is 3 to about 13 miles. With the future of our wilderness areas in the hands of those with boots on the ground, Jim Green Footwear and the Game Rangers Association of Africa have come together to make sure this issue is addressed with this boot. And as of today, we have hit over 1,200 pairs donated. All these boots will be on rangers' feet by the end of 2022. So once again, thank you to all of you for supporting the boot and its cause. Before we dive into the deconstructed boots on either side of me, let's have a look at some of the visual aspects that we can notice of these two boots. So to start, our Razorback boot, this is a 6-inch option at its highest point, whereas our African Ranger, this boot comes in at 4.5 inches, so it's more of a low-cut ankle boot. We then look at the weights of either boot. So a pair of size 8 Razorbacks, this weighs in at 1.5 kgs, whereas a pair of size 8 African Rangers comes in at 1.3 kgs. Another aspect to look at is that we use two different lasts on these styles. Our African Ranger, we use a last which we refer to as a STC last. Now this last is of a double E width and has quite a rounded toe box, which we have opted for because of the genuine toe cap that is on this boot. Our Razorback boot, we use a last which we refer to as the JG last. This is also a wide fitting last of a 2E width, but is slightly more snug and cozy above the toe box. This we'll also talk about further on in this video because this boot happens to be fully leather lined. So now let's have a look at the upper design of these boots and what's actually inside of each boot. So let's kickstart with our African Ranger boot. So if we turn this boot upside down, we can see here that this boot is put together with quite a few pieces of leather. So this helps us make a more affordable boot, although we still wanted to keep the boot very durable. So if we have a closer look here at the toe box, we have gone for a genuine toe cap. So we have got two layers of 2.2 millimeter full grain leather here, along with a thermoplastic toe puff. So once this is molded into place, you've got a pretty firm feel around the toe and really good support and protection. We have then doubled up on this leather around the facing of the boot. So once again here, we've gone for two layers of 2.2 millimeter full grain leather. And this then combines with a bellows tongue. If we have a look at the heel of this boot, once again, we have doubled up with two layers of full grain leather. And it may seem to you that there's no heel stiffener in this boot, but here we have positioned the heel stiffener in between these two layers of leather. So once this boot is in the factory and molded all together, all these components come together to make a very versatile, affordable, and lightweight boot. Now let's move on to our Razorback boot. One of the more noticeable differences between the Razorback and the African Ranger is that the Razorback has a single piece vamp. So what that means is that there's a solid piece of leather that runs all the way around the boot. Another big aspect of this boot is that this boot is fully leather lined with a calfskin lining. So you've got close on 5 millimeters of leather surrounding your foot, which is one of the reasons why this boot has been in our range since day one and today is our best selling boot. Another point to note on our Razorback boot is that as it is a 6-inch option and higher than our African Ranger, there's slightly more ankle padding, which provides that extra support. We have also cleverly dropped this ankle height at the heel region, which allows for a lot more flexibility when you're out on the trail or on the worksite. We've also opted on this boot to continue the padding through into the tongue. Now what this does is that it helps alleviate lace pressure, and with time and wear as the boots break in, you'll notice that the laces will naturally form to the shape of your feet. So now onto the midsole option of these two boots. So our African Ranger is a single lasted boot. So what this means is that the upper is placed onto the last, lasted over, and attached to the board with a double row of braided nylon cord for the stitch down construction. Now the Razorback, being a double lasted boot, is slightly more complicated. So what actually happens here is that the full grain leather upper is actually pulled away. And what we do is that we pull the calfskin lining around the last and under the lasting board. So the lining is pull toed over, and then at the second stage of the pull toe, the full grain leather upper is then pull toed over and flanged out. And once again, we apply a double row of braided nylon cord to our midsole. So the big difference here between the African Ranger and the Razorback is that the Razorback has a lasting board followed by the midsole, whereas the African Ranger just has the standard board midsole. So onto the last component of these two great boots, and that is the sole. Now being a stitched on construction boot, we are very fortunate that we can swap and change between sole options, but at the moment we're just going to run through our stock options that are available to you. So on the African Ranger, we just have the one sole option, which we refer to as our OR wedge sole. Now this sole is between a 55 and 65 shore hardness, which is on the slightly softer side. But being a wedge sole shape, it offers a lot more comfort. And due to the design of the sole, you're able to move through the bush very quietly and very nimble. Now this sole combines with this lightweight and simple construction to the upper to give you a very versatile boot. If we go across to our Razorback, here we've got a lug sole. Now here we use a much harder rubber, which can be between 75 and 85 shore hardness. Now this is because the Razorback obviously has a much higher and more heavier upper, so that it can handle a slightly heavier and harder sole. But due to the success of our wedge sole, we have recently added this, the Razorback with a wedge sole as a stock item. To sum it up, the Razorback is for those tough, rugged days with harsh terrain, with the leather lining being handy for wetter days as it makes it more water resistant, while the African Ranger, you're lighter on your feet and it is a more versatile boot that is well suited for warmer weather. So thanks very much for watching, and we hope that this video has been very informative and will help you make the correct decision to which boot will be best suited for your daily tasks. So please, in the comment section below, let us know there your experience with Gym Green footwear, and don't forget to like this video and hit that subscribe button.